Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone is doing good. Today's video we are going to do for using pencil colors. So in this one I will tell you how to layer the pencil colors and to get the maximum of the effect, like the realistic fur kind of effect, soft and fluffy fur as you can see in this reference picture. So I have already made the sketch, and if you want you can take the pencil to draw some direction of the fur so that when you are doing the color it becomes easy. I shall be using Polychromos from the Faber-Castell range, and I will layer the color here. I will swatch the color here, and I will try to use the nearest color possible, but sometimes we may not have the exact colors which are given in the reference picture, so that time you can pick the colors which are available with you to pick the nearest shade possible. So I have swatched the colors here guys, and these colors are also available in the Staedtler watercolor pencil, the Luna color set. So you can see these colors are almost similar, so whichever brand you want to use you can definitely use. And along with the yellow you can use some bright yellow, some golden yellow, and gray and black for giving the final shade. Okay, so these are the final colors which I will be using, and guys just make sure that you sharp your pencils well, because sharp pencils are very important to give that fine stroke and the effect of the fur. Initially you all can see the actual speed of my working, how I'm giving the fur here, just layering it slowly and softly. It's not a thing you need to do in a hurry. I mean, fur can look very simple, just you have to give the strokes, but once you study everything nicely and properly, you zoom in the picture, you understand the colors and the direction of the fur, that is again very important. If it's a very fluffy fur, it might have a certain direction. And layering of the colors, always go from the lighter shade to the darker shade from your color palette. Like you have chosen 3 to 4 colors, so you start with the lighter shade, then you build with the darker shade, and at the end you finish it off with a shading pencil like the gray or the black. At this point of time I'm going with the mustard yellow over the lighter yellow, and I have given the fine strokes very carefully, studying the proper direction. Now one thing you have to understand here is the direction of the fur and also the strokes. Let me show you here separately. When you are giving the fur, it should not be something like very straight lines. Always use curved kind of strokes, and when you are giving your pressure, start from a pressure point and just leave the pencil. So in this way you are putting a pressure at the starting point and just leaving it to give this very lighter stroke at the corner. So this is what you can just practice separately until you master the stroke and using this kind of curved manner. This particular pencil stroke, when you give it in multiple layers, gives the feel of very fluffy and soft look of the fur. So definitely try this one out, and also it's very fun to play with pencils to give different textures on the paper to depict different fabrics. As in our previous video we have done knitwear using pencils, so if you have not seen that video definitely go and check it out. You can click on this I button, or you can go directly to the description box. I will be posting all the links down there. So guys, one more thing which is important to understand is the pressure. Where you see little darker color, just put your pressure more to bring more of the color intensity, and where you see the lighter version of the color, just lower your pressures to give that lighter shade. Here I'm going with the third layer of the color using this kind of umber shade, and giving around the corners, like near the sleeves, near the folds. Here again you can see the actual speed of my working. This was very time consuming guys, and once you just understand the layering method, the direction of the fur, it becomes really easy. So just pay attention to this tiny details, and the layering is again very important. You should not over layer it, like one color should not overpower the other color. So I'm trying to find a balance between the golden tone of this color, like the mustard yellowish color and little bit of the brown. And going with the reference picture, I don't have the exact colors, as I have said before also, that sometimes we might not have the exact colors, but still I'm trying to study that in which place there is more of the darker color. So that darker color, I'm going with this one, this umber kind of shade. So here I'm just increasing the speed of the video, otherwise it will get too lengthy. If you want to see the slower version, you can definitely go to the settings and just decrease the speed and you can see the actual process again. Once I'm done with the brown shade, I will go with the mustard yellow again to blend in the darker shade. But I will try not to over blend it, otherwise the fur effect might not come out as effectively. So we don't need to over blend it. Just some light pressure of the yellow over the brown so that the brown color mixes really well with the overall color scheme. So guys, once I'm done with all the colors here, I shall use this gray color pencil to give that very fine strokes of the fur. If you zoom in the picture really close, you can see that direction of the fur in this very light grayish kind of shade. Now again, there are so many different shades of the gray, and this is the nearest color possible which I have, this shade of the gray. And also you can see some amount of the black wherever there are some folds or below the collar. So here we have to go with a very detailed manner of the fur. You can see the strokes which I'm giving with the gray in a very light shade. So in this manner we have to do, and there is nothing to hurry. This is little time consuming, but the overall result is going to be very effective. You can increase or decrease as per the requirement. At some places there might be little darker shade, so just increase the pressure there, and once it's done, you can blend again using the yellowish color. So again, it's a little important to blend the colors also so that the gray or the black doesn't overpower. Here you can see at the final stage I will be using the black, so that is the last color you are going to use for that extreme darkness around the folds, around the sleeves. Like here you can see there is a good amount of shade, so just there. And also for the very detailed look of the fur, you can give it, but it's not like very necessary. If you increase the amount of black, then it might be little on the darker shade. So again, it's very important that you go with the reference picture. Like if the color of the fur is on the darker side, like maybe red or very kind of dark blue, so at that moment you can use maximum of the black color. But here the color is on the brighter yellowish side, so I will not use more of the black. I will try to use the gray only for giving the shade. And also you can see I'm blending the color again just so that the black doesn't overpower everything. And here you can see guys, to give that very fine detail of the fur, I'm using my normal sketching pencil only. So there you can use just a pencil color. Even if you don't have a gray, you can use your pencil only, the sketching pencil, normal HP pencil or any mechanical pencil that can be used to give that final effect of the fur.
Thank you.
So finally guys, I'm done with the layering of the colors. At this moment my hand was paining a lot, but again no pain, no gain. I'm satisfied with the results. And for the final shade, I'm going with the black pencil. Here you can see the actual speed again. So everyone, I hope you enjoyed today's video. This was one of the requested video. If you have anything in mind, any particular fabric or techniques which I should try, then let me know in the comment section. But also go and check out the playlist. Maybe I have already made a video on that topic. So yes. And if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. I shall see you all very soon. Till then, take care. Keep illustrating. Bye-bye.